Okay. Hello, everybody. Today we'll start lab 5, dynamic programming problems. Objective of this lab will be show the advantage of dynamic programming technique or algorithms among other algorithms or methods. The background of this lab will be binomial coefficient and polynomial x plus y power n, which I upload to you in the OneDrive folder, revision of binomial coefficients for more details, okay? But in here, I summarize the binomial coefficient in polynomial, okay? So if you have x plus y power 4 or power 5, the terms here, the coefficient of terms, okay, will be x power 5 plus 5 x power 4 y plus 10 x power 3 y squared plus 10 x squared y3 plus 5 x y4 plus y5. Okay, as you can notice here, the exponent of each x and y will, the sum will be equal to n, like here, x4 plus y1, 1 plus 4, 5, 3 plus 2, 5, 2 plus 3, 5, even x5, y0 here. We have here y0, so 0 plus 5, 5, okay? The problem here, what are the coefficient of each term, okay? If we have x plus y power n, so for each term, the exponent of x called k here, the exponent of variable x, k, from will be from 0 to n. So for x equal, for x power k will be, the coefficient here will be combination n comma k equal n factorial over k factorial times n minus k factorial. So the general equation will be combinational n, n, x, n, y, 0, combinational n, n minus 1, x power n minus 1. So here, the k will be follow the x k here, okay? Plus, 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 n, 1, x, 1, y, n minus 1, plus n, 0, x, 0, y, 1. So for each coefficient, we must calculate the factorial, okay? If we have n terms here, so we have a power n, we have n plus 1 terms, as you can see. Look here, x power 5, x plus y power 5, we have 6 terms, not 5 terms, okay? So the number of coefficient will be n plus 1. Look here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Power 4, we have 5 terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? X2, X plus Y of power 2, we have 3 terms here. So for X plus Y power N, we have N plus 1 terms. So we have N plus 1 coefficient to calculate. So if we want to calculate each coefficient in factorial, sorry, in combinational here, factorials, the repeated computation of all the factorials get to be expensive. Okay, we'll see later in this lab, the if we use recursive algorithm, the complexity will be order of 2 power n to calculate this. So we can use dynamic programming to save the factorials. Okay, let's begin. Solution by dynamic programming, from bottom to up. So the advantage of dynamic programming is starting from bottom to up to eliminate the repetition of factorials. We'll see that later. So if n equal to 0, constant, equal 1, cn 0, 1. If x equal to 1, oh, sorry, n equal to 1 and x plus y only, so x plus 1, 1, 1, cn 1, cn 0. If we have x plus two, x plus y power 2, so we'll have 1, 2, 1. This is the factorials, okay? And so on, okay? So this is called, each row here will be depend in the previous row, okay? This is called Pascal triangle. Pascal is a French mathematical author. It's French, Pascal triangle. So the combinational of each n equals 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. So the equation here, it's not recursive. The equation here will be constant. Like example here. كفه اوكي كفه ام عنه انقطش رجع كفه غريبه اوكي لا look here if you want to calculate this term 21 will be equal to 6 plus 15 if you want to calculate here 3 will be equal 1 plus 2 3 here 1 plus 2 4 3 plus 1 10 6 plus 4, this 10, 4 plus 6, this 5, 1 plus 4, okay? So the Pascal equation, okay? So Pascal solve it using dynamic programming. So the Pascal equation, so will be CNK here equal CN minus 1, K minus 1 plus CN minus 1, K. يعني الرو انت نحن الرو نحن اللي فيه كل كوفيشن بهذا الرو in the same row will be equal the last row the last index the same index as you can see cnk equal cn minus 1k plus k minus 1 اللي حدا so هون عندنا example هون عندنا 7 الان 7 الk هون بال21 هي 0 1 2 3 4 5 so 5 So 6, So C 7, 6 will be equal to here, C 6, 6 plus C 6, 5. Hello, Sabine?
Yes, Sabine, I'm going to
say طلعت الكمبيوتر عندي شايفين الشاشه بعدكم؟
ايه
يلا مشيت الماوس راحت الماوس عندي اوكي so as you can see here 21 equals 6 plus 15 and so on so this is the equation cnk equals cn minus 1 k minus 1 plus cn minus 1 k so each value in the any row will be equal to sum all from the previous row اللي فوق دغري in between okay and cn0 equal cnn equal 1 اللي هن الطرف اذا بتلاحظوا على الطرف اذا بتلاحظوا على الباوندريز كله ones okay كله ones هن cn0 على طول باول رو okay باخر الرو في وانز هذا هو تريانجل باسكال للكوفيشنت سو هلا شرحناه كديفينيشنز ليتس كونتينيو تو ذا سوليوشن سوليوشن 1 باي ريكيرسيف الجوريزم ان سي اوكي سو وي كولد ات ا نايف ريكيرسيف امبلمنتيشن اور الجوريزم اوكي
لا تمشي يا ها بس الشاناشة لا
تمشي عشان بكره بيصح لك مشوار على المال بيها. في حدا فات او بالغلط اوكي سو هير اوكي ريكيرسيف الجوريزم سو وي ستارت فروم توب تو داون فروم توب تو داون وي ديفاين فانكشن كولد باينوميال كوفيشن توكس ان كي n number of the power of n and k is a position for each position so the base case is if k equal 0 or k equal n return 1 this is the boundaries as you can see okay as you can see here the boundaries okay ones so this is the equation cn 0 equal cnn equal to 1 okay now Okay, recursively, else if it's not true this, so we are inside the triangle. So recursively, return binomial coefficient to same function, n minus 1, k minus 1 plus, it's the same function, n minus 1, k, the equation above. Okay, that is, it's a very simple algorithm, very simple code. عم بتنطنط عند الماوس عم بتنطنط نطنط يلا اوكي ذا مين بادي ويل بي ذا مين كود ويل بي اكزامبل هير ان ايكوال 5 كي ايكوال 2 برنت اف فاليو اوف سي بيرسنت دي بيرسنت دي كولينج ذا فانكشن سو اكزامبل هير سي 5 2 از 10 اوكي as you can see here as you can see here we have overlapping sub problems It should be noted that the above function computes the same subproblems again and again. Example, see the following recursive tree. This is tree. As you can see, to solve combination of 5-2, we must solve it C4-1, C4-2. C4-1 will be C3-0 plus C3-1. Also, 4-2 will be C3-1, C3-2. As you can see here, we have subtree here, C3-1, we calculated once here, and again calculated here. Also, we calculate C2-1, 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 three times, and so on, and so on, and so on. So each subtree is calculated almost n minus one times, or almost n over two times, almost twice, or n over two times, if n is big. So the complexity will be order of 2 power n. Okay, this is the complexity of recursive algorithm because we divide it by two. Almost every combination will be sum of two, sum of two, sum of two, so 2 power n. But the advantage here, the space complexity will be constant, one space in the memory. Okay, we have only one variable in the memory, no stored value here. Always recalculate, recalculate, recalculate again. So this is called here, C3-1 here, and C3-1 here, subtree, the same, called overlapping subproblems. Okay? Since the same subproblems are called again, this problem has overlapping subproblems properties. So, the binomial coefficient problem has both properties 1 and 2 of a dynamic programming program. So we can use dynamic programming here. If we don't have the two properties, which are the revision here, we cannot use dynamic programming. But this example, we have overlapping and property 2. Look. It's the revision of dynamic programming in one, in half page. So, dynamic programming properties is an algorithm, it's a revision, it's an algorithm, paradigm, that solves a given complex problem by breaking out or into sub-problems and stores the result of sub-problems to avoid computing the same result again. This is very important here. It's like divide and conquer, but we have storing the value to avoid repetition, okay? Following are the two main properties of a problem that suggests that the given problem can be solved using dynamic programming. Okay, the two properties are overlapping subproblems, like divide and conquer dynamic programming, combines solution to subproblems. It's mainly used when solution of same subproblems are needed again and again. In dynamic programming, computing solution to subproblems are stored in a table or array so that these don't have to be recomputed. This is the advantage. So dynamic programming is not useful when there are no common subproblems or no overlapping. Okay? because there is no point storing the solution if they are not needed again. So in this example, we have overlapping. This is property number one. The property number two will be a given problem has optimal substructure properties. If optimal solution of the given problem can be obtained by using optimal solution of its sub problems. So